availability of info from products and components, machines, employees, suppliers, it's again interconnected through a system. Tracking and tracing of product. As I mentioned, the product knows what it is and what stage it is, where it has to go. And database to services and platforms. Automation and autonomization. So a lot of autonomy comes to the machines. So you may not even need lighting or air conditioning in certain production atmospheres because you are going to remotely manage. For example, people are even deploying huge solar systems in deserts because you can remotely monitor them, you can remotely service them, and so that kind of autonomization is also there. Collaborative robots, humans and robots working together in synchronization. Cobots is the latest jargon. And real-time process control and autonomous optimization and decision making. So, for example, in the MSME scenario, even the current legacy systems, you could start implementing by connecting some of the sensors, at least to check if the machine is running or not, and the production details, all this could be again uploaded into the cloud. You have camera-based monitoring systems. So somewhere, even at a rudimentary level, this automation culture has to set in. The other aspect is human technology intervention. So it's not going to be standalone. While the predictions are it is going to replace humans, probably humans are replaced for better intelligent and smart work. So the interaction is going through smart devices and apps, glasses, web technology, VR and AR, again part and parcel of this, human-robotic collaboration. You will also have intelligent assistants, Sophias, which you have seen, interactive shop floor communication, more virtual mobile work instead of controlled factory work. This I'll come in a minute. Again, it's a schematic diagram where the physical processes and the cyber systems, both are interconnected through these communication layers, so just for your understanding. The factory of the future will look like this. You have predictive machine analytics to predict the order patterns, raw material, the other resources available. Industrial augmented reality, again, there is a human-machine interface at every stage. And the production is continuously monitored. Modular equipments are there for custom manufacturing. So each of those production processes, a lot of customization is going to happen. Computer vision is coming heavily in inspection and product quality and even process monitoring. Cobots, which I mentioned. The blockchain for this order processing, because it has to be managed at the distributed registry level. Orders are triggered automatically, funds are transferred automatically. Again, that need to have lots of security systems in place. So again, you have your analytics, big data, security, software in place for triggering alerts or anomalies. Then you also have logistics where drones and unmanned rigs are going to be in the order of the day. Electric vehicle was indicated, but the next stage is autonomous trucks. So even coast to coast, long distance driving, when the roads get smarter, the vehicles pick and move on their own. Some of the challenges, generally, especially in the MSME sector, lack of a clear digital operation vision, unclear economic benefit, so how much I am going to invest and what is the return on these automation initiatives. Again, such things come with the high cost of capex, so the systems have to be redone, and a lot of questions on data security because the control goes to the devices from the physical controls. Again, the standards are evolving, we don't have too much of norms and certification as on today. Even in share trading, algorithm trading, only 6 months ago, some clear guidelines were given by SEBI. Until then, it was easy, and the cryptocurrency was banned. So again, there's an interplay of policy and political will to implement such systems. And there is again, it has to be supplemented with the basic infrastructure networks. So, two more minutes. So the fourth industrial revolution is not just about technology and the business alone, it has to encompass the society at large. Obviously, when humans and machines work together, there are going to be a good number of challenges. Role of people, workers, are they going to be workers or employees or service providers? Because it's a smart work, work from a different location, work remotely, work from home. So all these are changes. The change management, how is that it's going to be handled? Is it going to be wage, salary or remuneration? Advanced countries, Nordic countries also started debates on universal basic income. Machines let them do the work, so the society, the people get some basic assured income for their livelihood, and so that's a kind of debate. In terms of technology, legacy systems, it's a huge burden. How are we going to dispose them or retrofit them, convert them into smart? The migration issues, associated cost, again, the trustworthiness, safety, resilience, privacy, even the recent example of Alexa hearing some private conversations, there are challenges. So if everything is automated, if there is no reliability, how do we handle this? So interestingly, this is again 2-3 days ago, in Sweden, thousands of people are getting chips embedded into that. So human beings may not be standalone human beings 20 years later. Now itself is started. So this chip will help them to even travel in a bus without paying, because the chip takes care of the payment. So this culture has started. So days are not too far for such systems to percolate our regions. So singularity is predicted in next 20, 30 years. So singularity means the machine's capability surpassing the human capabilities. So there is an exponential increase in technologies. We need to overcome this chasm, the divide that in terms of the infra, which we talk about, but combinatorial technologies are at play, and there's going to be abundance in energy, abundance in water, and abundance in skills. This is again transhumanism. Are we ready becoming part machine and part human being? So for MSMEs, I think this is more of opportunity to embrace for survival and growth and development. Thank you all for this time. And, thanks for hearing me.